enter until you go buy a real ticket. Well, sir, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God until you have the real ticket. And it's a ticket bought by the blood of Jesus Christ. And the price you will have to pay is to enter through the narrow gate and be crucified. And some of you don't even know where the narrow gate is. It's so far away from you, it seems crazy to even try to find the narrow gate. The narrow gate can only be found on your knees, confessing your sins. The narrow gate can only be seen by those who are willing to repent and turn aside from all wickedness. The narrow gate requires a crucifixion. Crucifixion of the old nature. Until that's taken place, you will not receive the ticket to enter into the kingdom of God. And if you lose the ticket on your way, you can arrive at the concert and you can say to the usher, "Sir, I bought a ticket for this program, but somehow I lost it. Would you please let me in anyway?" What do you think are the chances that he will let you into that concert down at the Kennedy Center? I can assure you there is not one chance in 100 that he will allow you to enter into that concert. He will simply say, "I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry that you lost your ticket, but you cannot enter without the ticket. I have to see proof that you paid the price, that you met the conditions." If you arrive at the celestial city, at the judgment bar of God, and he says to you, "Do you have the ticket?" And you say to him, "I did buy the ticket, sir, but I lost it on the journey." He'll say, "I'm sorry, you cannot enter. I have to have proof that you've paid the price." And of course, the proof that you've paid the price is living a godly life, not walking in sin, bending every energy for the kingdom of heaven, walking with integrity before God, walking in love with brothers and sisters, having no bitterness in your heart, no jealousy, no envy, no gossip, no gluttony, walking clean before God. No sexual uncleanness, not even a hint of sexual uncleanness. No stealing, no lying, no drugging, no lusting after the entertainment of the world. If you do those things, you have lost your ticket. And you must go back and find the ticket again. Many of you listening today need to go back and get the ticket because you've lost it. You may have once been born again, but now you walk in rebellion against God. You love the things of this world. You walk in the things of flesh. You live like the world lives. You talk like the world. You act like the world. You curse like the world. You use the F word. You lie. You lust after money. Do you think there's even a faintest possibility of your being allowed into the celestial city? I can assure you there is not one chance in a million that you will enter into that celestial city, for no sin can darken that city's gate. Nothing unclean can enter that gate. You have to be washed in the blood. You have to enter through that narrow gate, that groaning, suffering gate. You must pay the price if you are to enter into heaven. And many of you have been deceived, because like ignorance, you go to church, you pay your tithes, you talk the talk, you talk about Jesus, you have the theology, you know all the answers, but you don't walk the walk. You walk like the world. You live like the world. You sound like the world. How do you think you can possibly be saved? What are you saved from? If you say to me, Pastor, I'm saved, I say to you, what are you saved from? Are you saved from your sin? If you're not saved from your sin, you're not saved. That's what Jesus came to do. He came to save us from our sins. Have you been saved from your sin? Our phone number in studio is 877-534-0780. Don't call unless you're serious. Don't play games with God. If you're not under deep conviction, don't call with some foolish comment. Call and be honest about your spiritual condition. Call and ask me to pray with you. Call and confess your sins. Get right with God. Come to the mourner's bench. Weep and wail before God. Don't think you're going to waltz into the kingdom of God. Don't think you're going to dance your way into salvation. It's not going to happen. The gospel is very clear. And even this dear brother, John Bunyan, who was a Reformed Baptist, he's very clear. He confronts ignorance. He confronts the deception of ignorance, who thinks he can just waltz in from a crooked path and enter into salvation. Can't do it. Impossible. You cannot enter into the kingdom of God and carry your burden of sin. The cross is for the cutting away of your burden of sin. It's for setting you free. Don't play with the grace of God. If you need to call, if you need to confess sin, if you need to get right, that's what this time is about. That's all I care about, is finding men and women who will repent of their sin, who will get clean before God, who will walk in righteousness, who will join me on this journey toward heaven. Our phone number is 877-534-0780. Chris, welcome. What would you like to share?
Pastor, I'm calling. I'm at a loss right now. I'm consumed with Jesus in heaven, and I've forsaken, you know, most of the things of this world to the extent that I feel like I can't even fit in, and I even despair of life. I'm out of work. I'm bankrupt. I don't have the means to pay my rent. I don't know how many days that I have before I'll end up on the street, and I find it difficult to even, because I want to be so reliant upon God and upon Jesus day by day and breath by breath. I spend my time in my prayer closet, and I cease striving, but the circumstances of life continue to deteriorate, and you know, as a pilgrim, I don't even long for any of these things. Nevertheless, just I can't seem to even secure the minimum amount of what's required to even to live a life at this point, and I'm so confused about my discernment and where my leadership comes from, whether the Lord is speaking to me, or whether the enemy is slipping in and misguiding me and throwing me off, and I just keep tripping up, and I can't seem to even get the smallest level of stability to even make a meager existence here, and I just don't know. I feel so confused.
Do you have paper or pencil close by?
I do.
write down Romans 12, verses 1 and 2.
Present yourselves.
Living martyr to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Okay? And then also write down Matthew, the 6th chapter. Read verses 25 through 34.
Matthew 6:33 is the verse on which I've built my life, and even that, you know, I know God is going to give me enough for this day and this day, and he will give me, he'll supply all my needs and not my wants. I just am running out of
Chris,
any type.
Chris,
I don't know.
Chris, I want to tell you, I have been right where you are at. Ready to be kicked out of the house, the utilities turned off, no food, starving, laying before God, saying, I will not move until God answers and directs my steps. And God answered miraculously. I have been there many times.
It seems to be my life now for several years.
I understand. And God is dealing with your heart, and he's going to get to the very bottom of the issue. What's essential now is that you spend the time before him and do exactly what he tells you to do. Now, I'm going to tell you, in my case, what he did. He spoke to me and he said, will you receive only from my hand what I choose to give you? And I said, yes. That afternoon, there was a knock on the door and groceries arrived. The next day, there was a knock on the door and there was a man I had met at the mall, and we had talked about the gospel. And he said to me, the Lord told me to come and get you and take you to see an attorney. Would you go meet him? And I said, yes. I went and met with that attorney. The attorney said, Pastor, what can I do for you? I said, I don't have any idea what you can do for me. I don't know why I'm here. He smiled and he said, Pastor, I have some precious gems. If you will go and sell them, I will give you 15% of everything that you make, that you sell. I said, I know nothing about gems. He went to his safe, he took out a briefcase, and in that briefcase was $250,000 of gems. Sapphires, one beautiful 17-carat sapphire, an incredible stone. He had many beautiful stones, garnets and rubies, and incredible, and all of them were in baggies, and each of them with a carat weight and a price list. I waited until the repo man left, and my wife and I got in the car with a little bit of gas we had and drove into Barstow, California, and there was a gem show. We went in, we talked with one of the dealers, and he said, I'm interested. Come back after the show this evening. We came back. He bought just over $50,000 worth of gems. I took them back to the attorney the next day, and he gave me 15% of that $50,000+. It paid everything off, and then I had nothing left and was waiting again on God. And that's when the Lord said to me, go back to Washington, D.C. and wait on me. And I came back to Washington, and for the next 5 years, I was homeless. I was invited to live with a pagan couple in a tiny little bedroom, in a tiny little house in Baltimore. And for 5 years, I was hidden away just reading the scripture and praying. And at the end of that 5 years, a total of 7 without any public ministry, the Lord said, now start the National Prayer Chapel. And that's when he introduced me sovereignly to David Wilkerson at Times Square Church. And David Wilkerson stepped forward and funded the opening of the National Prayer Chapel, giving over $150,000 total over a period of some years. Never once did I ask for any money from anyone. God sovereignly brought it. Chris, what I'm saying to you is you're exactly where God wants you to be. Don't be confused and don't be discouraged. Stand by faith that he will order your steps and tell you exactly what he wants you to do and exactly where he wants you to go. And if he wants you to have a job, he will bring that job to you. If he wants you in that house, he'll pay the rent. If he doesn't want you in that house, he'll have you out of that house and he'll show you where to go.
He's blessed me also with stewardship and has put a calling on my life where I've rescued animals as well. And I've asked him, do I maintain the care for these animals or do you want me to give them away? And he's told me, until I tell you to give them away, you are to just keep them. But I everything about me and the influences I have in my life and my family is here. They're not believers. Their advice is always so practical and so worldly. Get rid of your animals. Just go get a job. It doesn't matter what it is. Go pound the pavement. And they'll help me. Like you said, don't take anything from Pharaoh. And the only people that will even help me are family. And then obviously they have expectations that have nothing to do with Jesus. And there's so much guilt and there's just so much confusion.
So go into the prayer closet, Chris, and cry out to God about this until the answer comes.
I will. And that's what I do. And I guess, like you said, if it takes years, it will take years. But I will stay at it.
I mean, Chris, when you listen to me do this broadcast, I had no one to help guide my feet in this journey. I wish I'd had someone I could listen to who had been down that journey, down that road. My family cut me off. They said I'm insane because I will not work. They wouldn't even speak to me for 5 years. They said, you're crazy. You've gone fanatical.
Yes.
All I want is Jesus.
Me too.
Okay, so don't allow confusion to enter into your heart. Be absolutely faithful as a servant before God to everyone around you, including those precious animals and your family. Be servant to everybody. No pride, no arrogance, no hardness, no argumentativeness, no confusion. Be crystal clear. You will follow Jesus, and you are at total odds with the culture around you, but follow Jesus.
Amen.
Okay? Let me pray for you. Lord, I know you are bringing forth men and women who are going through the fires right now, and you intend to bring them forth like gold that was tried in the fire. You will give them the power of your Holy Spirit to speak with such authority that the walls of hell will shake. Lord, I pray for Chris, I pray that you will open the way before him with provision for his daily bread, for a roof over his head. I pray, Lord, you will not pierce him with homelessness as you did me. But, Lord, whatever you need to do in Chris's life, do what you need to do to bring him through the fire that he could be a mighty testimony for you, Jesus. Wash him today. Take the confusion out of his heart. Don't let him be confused by the lies of Satan. But keep his feet, Jesus, on that straight and narrow road that he will walk faithfully before you. And Lord, I pray your blessing on his family. I pray your loving mercy for them. I pray you will give Chris favor with everyone he meets. Lord, cause them to know that they are dealing with a man who is sold out to you, Jesus. Let there be no flesh in Chris's heart. I pray in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, Chris.
Thank you, brother.
Stay in touch.
Yes.
We have just a minute left. Brother Tom, we have just 1 minute. Say it quick.
Oh, okay. I didn't know I called so late. I didn't hear the whole broadcast. Just heard the beginning of it. But, one, I just want to say you made me spiritually jealous. I wasn't there last night. Maybe I came on the wrong Tuesday. Yeah. It was good to see you last week. And, second, I was thinking of Matthew 25 as you were talking about the man that went down the crooked gate, the five wise and the five foolish virgins.
Yes.
And it's so easy to be deceived because those five foolish virgins looked really good.
And Tom, it's a spirit of religion that is absolutely wicked, where we think we're comfortable and we've got it together and we're on our way, but we know in our heart we're lusting after darkness and we're walking in foolishness.
Yes.
Yes. Amazing.
And especially the pride of religion is unbelievable. The deception of it is actually incredible.
And we all have to cry out against it, Tom.
Amen. Amen. Any of us are liable to slip into that.
God bless you, brother. I have to go.
Okay. All right. God bless.
I'd like to just very quickly invite you to go to the webpage, nationalprayerchapel.com. That's nationalprayerchapel.com. You can download this broadcast either by video or podcast. And I'm going to give you my personal cell phone number, 703-489-1785. That's 703-489-1785. If you need to pray and confess sin and deal with issues, then you're welcome to call me. Don't call if you want to argue. Call if you want to get clean. I'm Ray Greenlee. You've been listening to Pilgrim's Progress. I pastor the National Prayer Chapel in Woodbridge, Virginia. Come see us. God bless you. I'll talk to you soon. His glory with great joy. With great joy. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory.